This is the EWN Radio Network. Welcome to Thriving Entrepreneur with your host, Steve Kidd, third-generation minister and business coach. Join Steve and his guests to get answers to your questions and help break through to the next level in your business.
This is Steve. Welcome to Thriving Entrepreneur. I'm so glad you decided to join us. Some of you may be listening live, and it is for you towards the end of 2015. And those of you that are listening to this after the start of 2016, I want to encourage you that whenever you're listening to this, it is the perfect time, perfectly appointed for you to hear this message. Today, we are going to empower you with some new skills, some new techniques that are going to allow you the ability to live a more powerful, more impactful, better life from now on than you've lived to this point forward. Often, we find ourselves challenged with the stories that go through our mind. You heard Tia talk just last week about us needing to press pause on the negative and play on the powerful. And today I have got another great thought leader for you, Noah St. John, who is going to talk to us today about affirmations, about how you can say the things and do the things in your life that are going to empower you to do more, to do better, to be greater with every day of your life so that you can thrive in your life and business. And you know that that's what we're here for, is to help you thrive in all that you do. Join me in welcoming Noah St. John. Hi, Noah. How are you today?
Welcome, Steve. Thanks for having me on the show today.
Yeah, absolutely. So I had the privilege of being a very small part of a webinar you were in back in June, I think it actually was, and was just blown away with affirmations and all that you teach about. But for those who have never heard of you or aren't really sure what you're all about, tell us a little bit about who you are and what got you to this point.
Well, Steve, I'm just a regular guy and who really wanted a better life. I grew up poor in a rich neighborhood, and I know that's a total cliche, but that's the truth. I grew up in a little town called Kennebunkport, Maine, which just happens to be one of the wealthiest communities in New England, but my family was dirt poor, and I mean that literally. We lived at the bottom of a dirt road in a drafty, unfinished house that my parents lost to foreclosure eventually, and so it was a real dichotomy growing up with that in a household with scarcity and poverty and lack and fear, but yet I was surrounded by all this wealth and abundance. So it was really weird. And so as a kid, you're just like, that doesn't make any sense. You know, how come some people have so much and my family has nothing? And so, I went on a really long quest, I guess, to answer that question. And I started reading lots of spiritual growth, self-help, personal growth books, just went on a very long journey, like I said, to try to answer that question. And many years later, I just had this epiphany, really, an experience that really changed my life. And I was able to share it with a lot of people around the world. And, we've had a lot of people say that it's subsequently changed their lives, making money and losing weight, finding love, quitting smoking, overcoming addiction, and just a lot of pretty amazing things that have happened because of this this new technology that really is available to anybody.
Great. So introduce it to us. Tell us what it is that you've discovered that helps people so much.
Well, sure. So I'm sure everybody listening to your program is familiar with affirmations, right? An affirmation is what they teach in all those success books, right? They say that you say these statements, these positive statements over and over, and that's supposed to change your beliefs, and so thereby changing your life. And, that makes logical sense, and I'm sure many people have tried it. And, you know, so for some people it works fine, some it doesn't work so much. And so I was one of those people that it didn't work very well because I was, you know, saying the statements, doing everything they said, and I was going, why isn't my life changing? How come I'm still banging my head against the wall here? Nothing's really changing. And then one night in April 1997, I was 20, well, at that point I was a 30-year-old college student and a religious studies major and living in this tiny little dorm room with all of my worldly possessions. And the room was so small, if you stood in the middle of the room and put your arms out to both sides, you could touch the walls on both sides. That's how tiny this room was with all my worldly possessions. And I said, something's wrong here. I've been reading all these books for all these years, and this is it? This doesn't make any sense. There's got to be something missing here. I don't understand. So I was very frustrated, and I was looking around my little room, and I noticed that there were all these little pieces of paper that I'd written these statements on, these positive statements. I'm happy, I'm wealthy, I'm abundant. Why had I done that? Well, because, of course, every book tells you to do it. So I did what they said. Now, what I realized is that, you know, not only was I not those things, but now I felt even worse because I've been doing this for so long and it's still not working. So now I felt even worse. So went to bed that night, you know, really frustrated, but I got up the next morning, got in the shower, you know, just like any other morning, but all these thoughts were rattling around in my head. And I realized, you know, you ever have those moments in the shower, you know, those aha moments, those epiphanies? And I'm sure many people have had that. We all kind of have those ideas in the shower. And I said, well, this is really what I call it in my book, Steve. I call it the shower that changed everything. Because I realized that I was thinking about all of this that I just shared with you, and that how come I've been reading these books, doing everything they said, and yet it's not working? And I said, there's got to be a better way, but what is it? And I said, well, what are we really talking about? Well, we're talking about beliefs. And I said, well, what is a belief? Well, a belief is a thought. And I said, well, what is a thought? What is a thought? And the more that I thought about that question, I said, you know, the process of human thought is the process of searching for answers to questions. For example, if I were to ask you this question right now, and, you know, for everybody listening, you can play along, right? And I like to do this at my seminars and live events. I say, okay, I'm going to ask you guys a question, and now let me know what happens in your brain. And so the question I ask is, why is the sky blue? Why is the sky blue? Now, when I ask that question, what immediately starts to happen in your brain?
You're trying to figure out exactly why is the sky blue.
Exactly. And so what you're really saying is you're searching for the answer to the question, right? And I said, no, that happens automatically without your volition. So I said, well, wait a sec. If the human mind is automatically searching for answers to questions, why are we going around making statements that we don't believe? You see, because the problem isn't with the statement. The problem is we don't believe the statement. Right? So you say something like, I am happy, I am rich, I am successful. And your brain's going, no, you're not. Right? I don't feel rich. I don't have any money. I'm not successful. Right? And so it's what I call the yeah, right response. Your brain goes, yeah, right. So what the traditional teachers taught us is that if you just repeat it 1,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000, buffered. So I said, well, wait a second, there's got to be a better way. There's got to be a faster and easier way than that. So, because what they're really saying is, well, all you have to do is ask your brain into submission. And, you know, like I said earlier, sometimes it works, and for some people it works, but some people it doesn't work at all. And in fact, I've had many, many people tell me over the years that, you know, using the affirmation, the old method, just made them feel worse. And actually, scientific studies have shown that to be true. And so I said, okay, well, if that's the case, and now I see that the human mind is automatically searching for answers to questions, why don't we just cut out the middleman? Why don't we just get right to the question? And I said, well, what would that look like? This was a really long shower, by the way. And I said, well, what would the question be? So let's take a classic affirmation or positive statement. I am rich. Right? You say, I am rich. And your brain says, yeah, right. Right? It's that yeah, right response that I talked about. So I said, well, okay, if that's the statement, what would the question be? Why am I so rich? Why am I so rich? Now, when you ask that question, what immediately starts to happen in your brain?
You start looking for the answer to why you're so rich.
Exactly. You start to search for the answer. So what we're really talking about is the law of sowing and reaping, right? As you sow, so shall you reap. Now, this is, of course, nothing new. It's been taught for centuries. But what are we really sowing? Well, we're sowing seeds of thought. But what are most people doing? Sowing lousy thought seeds. Mm. So most people are going around saying something like this. Why am I so broke? Why am I so fat? Why can't I lose weight? How come I can't quit smoking? Why does nothing ever work out? How come I can't catch a break? Why is there more month left at the end of the money? Right? And you ask lousy questions, what do you get?
Lousy answers.
Right. And that means a lousy life. So I said, well, wait a second. What if instead of asking lousy questions that lead to lousy answers and create a lousy life, what if we flip the whole thing on its head, start asking empowering questions that lead to phenomenal answers and create a wonderful life? And as I was standing there in the shower, April 1997, I said, holy cow, I think I just invented something. Hmm. And so I had to give it a name, and the name that I gave it was, as you mentioned, Afformations, which is spelled A-F-F-O-R. M-A-T-I-O-N-S, affirmations. And by the way, a lot of people ask me, well, where did that word come from? How did you come to invent that word, affirmations? Well, the word affirmation, the statement, the one that we're all used to hearing, comes from the Latin word firmare, which means to make firm. Now, the word affirmations that I invented, and by the way, it's perfectly legitimate to invent a new word. When you have a new way of looking at the universe or a new technology, isn't it true we often need a new word? For example, Google, internet, software, webinar, all of these things. There's so many new words now that we have every day that we use, but they've only been around a very, very short time. Now we use them every day, but they're a new technology, so we needed a new word. Well, what I'm sharing with you and what I share in my books is a new technology of the mind. So the word affirmations comes from the Latin word formare, F-O-R-M-A-R-E, formare, which means to form or give shape to. So the question that I often ask my seminar audiences or my coaching clients is, what if you're making something firm, but it's in the wrong form? That's called forming a life you didn't want. Why am I so broke? Why am I so fat? Why can't I lose weight? Why can't I make more money? You formed it unconsciously. You didn't do this consciously, but it doesn't matter because of the law of sowing and reaping. It doesn't matter, right? The law is the law. And so you formed it, it became firm, and now there's your life. But now using affirmations for the first time, you can take conscious control of the questions you're asking, change your questions, and change your life.
I think that makes a lot of sense. It's interesting that you said that you were a religious studies major, because as a third generation minister, you and I could both geek out on Bible stuff all the rest of this show. but I often teach, because often as a coach, the very first thing you got to work on is a person's mindset. They can't really go anywhere until they get their mind in a place where they can go somewhere. And one of the VIP days I actually spend with people, I talk to them about the whole concept of the Bible verse, faith is evidence, faith is substance. And what I'm showing them, not so much from a sermon perspective, but from the concept of the fact that you have the ability to have belief, that you can even believe for something that isn't right now, is the solid thing that you can hold on to then begin to change your circumstance. The fact that you were even made that way is what then gives you the capability to then be able to learn and grow. So it's interesting that where you've taken that from. I really like that.
Thank you.
I hope that that was an epiphany for some of you, and that you can realize right here, right now, in this moment, that when I say things like you were fearfully and wonderfully made, that that isn't just me trying to be all spiritual on you, but it is me encouraging you that you are here for a purpose. You are not an accident, and the world needs absolutely and totally who you are and what you bring to the planet. So don't undermine yourself. Don't undercut yourself. You are here for a reason. And to be honest, I know that we're glad you're here. You're listening to Thriving Entrepreneur. We'll be right back.
I'm looking for a certain kind of woman, and I think you know her. She's an entrepreneur that is highly connected, successful, significant in her own industry, and considered the go-to woman in her community. She's received so much from so many women in business, she's ready to give back to others on their journey, lifting as she climbs. Hi, this is Sandra Yancey, and I'm the founder and CEO of eWomen Network. I'm looking to connect with the woman I've just described who lives in your community so that we might have a conversation about how eWomen Network's proven success system can provide her a platform to elevate her success and ability to support women in business. Our international community of managing directors are influencing the speed of success for women in business around the world. If that sounds like something that you want to be part of or know someone we should talk with, send an email to managingdirector@ewomennetwork.com. That's managingdirector@ewomennetwork.com, and let's start the conversation.
Are you ready to be a celebrity expert in your field? Are you your own best kept secret? Do you have talents you want to share with the world? Are you ready to be seen as an authority? Do you have a message you need to share with the world? You know to your core you can help people if you could just reach them. Kathy and I want to help you share your unique brilliance with the world. Are you ready for this? How would you like to be recognized on top media outlets? What would becoming an Amazon bestseller do for your business? How many people could you inspire? And it doesn't take a lifetime. It doesn't take years. It doesn't take months. In fact, in just 60 minutes, you will become a celebrity expert in your field. In 30 days, you will be a best-selling author, and you will be seen on NBC, CBS, ABC, CNN, Fox, and the Wall Street Journal. How does this work? Well, you'll be interviewed on our show, Thriving Entrepreneur, which will then be broadcast on Blog Talk Radio, iTunes, Stitcher, and many others, as well as promoted to a network that has a database of over 500,000 people. Your expert interview will be published in your very own book, which is guaranteed to hit best-selling author status on Amazon. Your name and the book title will appear in major media outlets, including ABC, NBC, Fox, CNN. We can guarantee that. Plus, as a bonus, you'll get a custom social media package to promote your book and an MP3 of your interview with 5 key tips on how you can repurpose the content for marketing and sales. Don't be the best kept secret. Get ready to play an A game and be the authority in your field. Go to wehelpyouthrive.com and click on the authority package to get yours today.
Welcome back to Thriving Entrepreneur.
This is Steve. Welcome back. I'm here with Noah St. John. We are talking about affirmations, how you can control the destiny of your life by the things that you ask yourself, rather than living in a place where you just take life as it comes. You actually can direct your thoughts and move your mind forward into a better place. So let's dive deep into the concept of affirmations. I know one of the things that a lot of experts are saying has to do with stress-free prosperity. So many huge words in that statement. what is stress-free prosperity?
Well, Steve, on our campus, we use that phrase. We call that, you know, when you have an abundant life or a life of abundance or, you know, stress-free abundance, stress-free prosperity, whatever you want to call it, financial freedom, freedom, whatever it is. Again, it's, you know, it's up to you. But on our campus, that's the phrase we use. And what we like to do is show people that it really comes down to four elements of a life of stress-free prosperity. And those elements are time, energy, relationships, and money. Now, when you have an abundance of those four elements, then you're living what, you know, you could call an abundant life or life of stress-free prosperity. So if you look at those four elements, you know, we start with the element of time because time really is the most valuable resource because it's the only one that can never be replaced. All of Bill Gates' billions can't buy 1 minute of yesterday. And so time is the most valuable resource. However, isn't it funny that we don't treat it that way? You know, we say things like, well, oh, I'll get around to that later. Or, oh, I just don't have the time. And, you know, these are all lies that we tell ourselves just to, you know, kind of stay in a rut or stay in the same kind of habits that we've been doing. So what I like to say to people is, you know, listen, if you don't take that action, you know, it's never going to happen. Someday isn't one of the days of the week. So if there's something that's important to you, you've got to make it a priority. And also, you know, if you're feeling like I have too much to do and too little time, well, that means you're not experiencing an abundance of time, right? So that might be an area of stuckness for some people. For many people, it is. Then the area of energy. You know, imagine if you had $1 million but no energy to enjoy it with. Well, then, of course, that's not an abundant life. And so a lot of people are misusing energy. Energy is also about emotion because energy emotion is energy in motion, right? So a lot of people are using their energy against themselves, whether in depression or sadness or anger. You know, sometimes they're lashing out with negative emotions, whether it's, you know, being angry all the time or what have you. So there's that quality as well. So if you're feeling stuck in energy, that's another area of stuckness. The third area is relationships. And imagine if you have $1 million and no one to enjoy it with. That's not abundance. That's not an abundant life. And so notice that relationships, both I'm talking about in your personal life as well as your professional life, in your career or your business. You know, for those of you listening who own a business, for example, I mean, your business is all about relationships, and relationships all come down to really one singular element, which is trust. And when you look around the world today, you see that trust is really the thing that's in the greatest demand and the lowest supply, right? I mean, there's just so little trust right now with government, with institutions, with corporations, and you know, even with other people. So if you are experiencing stuckness or any kind of breaks in relationship, it always comes down to trust. And then the fourth element of an abundant life is, of course, money. You want to have that experience of money. Money doesn't buy happiness, but it does buy a yacht that you can pull up next to happiness in. That's what David Lee Roth said. Anyway, but my point is that, of course, yeah, we do want to have that. We don't want to be stuck in money or any of those other areas as well. So just notice, you know, even on a scale of 1 to 10, you can just do like a quick self-check-in and say, gosh, you know, am I feeling stuck in time, energy, relationships, or money, or all of those? A lot of people come to me, Steve, and they say, man, no, I'm stuck in all of these things. And, you know, that's why, you know, a lot of the programs and books and so forth, programs that we have, are enabling people, you know, empowering people really to get unstuck in all of those areas.
So is there a number one thing that keeps people stuck? I mean, is there like just... I mean, I know that I'm sure there's a ton of them, but is there a number one thing that it's like, this is the first thing that everybody has to address?
Well, I think you really mentioned it before when you were talking about the mindset. And that really is very important. What we talk about on our campus is inner game and outer game. So the inner game are the things that happen between your ears that you can't see directly, but you see the effects of them. Things like your beliefs, your thoughts, your priorities, your decisions. Those are all, they happen in your brain, in your head, but you don't see them directly, but you see the effects of them. And then you have the outer game, which is the things you can see, your habits, your lifestyle, your systems, strategies. If you own a business, you know, your customer service, your website, or whatever. If you're in a career, you know, who you're talking to and how you're talking to them. If you're making sales presentations, you know, communication skills, all of those outer game things. So what's really crucial, what we've seen, is that when there's a disconnect or an imbalance between either your inner game or your outer game, that's what's going to really cause the stuckness. So it really comes down to either of those or both. A lot of people come to me and they do say, you know, Noah, when I heard you talk about inner game and outer game, I realized I'm actually kind of stuck in both of those things. So that's why, you know, like I said, we have things to help you in inner game and in outer game, because it's only when you put those two things together that you have long-term success.
So, I mean, I think it's really interesting that so often we tend to, you know, maximize the negative and de-emphasize the positive. And I know in some of the notes that that you sent over when I was prepping for the interview, you talked a lot about the miracle of positive self-talk. Can you share that a little bit more with the listeners?
Well, that really didn't come from me, Steve. What's so neat about that is that that's what people have called, you know, are calling affirmations, my affirmations method. They, you know, they call it things like the missing piece to a life of abundance. I mean, I've had people write to me and say, Noah, thank you for giving me the missing piece that I've been looking for 20 years. We had one fellow at one of our live events. We do a live event twice a year. And he stood up and he said, Noah, I have been on a search, you know, on a quest, a mission, just to try to find myself, or, you know, to have, you know, these answers for 40 years. He says, I've got a PhD in psychology. And he said, these secrets, these strategies, these principles that you've taught us over these last 2 days is greater than the last 40 years of study. I mean, that was pretty incredible when he said that. So, and he also said, oh, by the way, and I just wrapped up a $1 million deal as a result of learning this. I was like, well, that was pretty sweet. So, I mean, you know, I think that's what it is. I mean, you know, these aren't the when you say the miracle of positive self-talk, that didn't come from me. It came from other people talking about this method. That, yes, we are all talking to ourselves all the time. And as you just said, most people are talking in the negative. How come I'm so stupid? How come I'm so fat? Why can't I lose weight? Why can't I get ahead? How come things aren't working out? How come so-and-so has so much more than I do, right? And for example, just going on social media, for example, there have been numerous studies recently that show that the more time you spend on social media, the worse you feel about yourself, because you're comparing your life to the highlights of other people, right? So let's say you're on Facebook, right, and you're just spending a lot of time surfing Facebook and seeing what other people are doing. Well, it's pretty obvious that people are only putting the highlights, like, hey, here I am on the beach, and here I am windsurfing, and here I am, you know, whatever. I don't, you know, cutting a ribbon. I don't know. But you see what I'm saying? They're only giving you the highlights. And what happens is people compare their normal life to somebody else's highlights. So they've literally shown that the less time you spend on social media, the happier you get. Isn't that funny? So that's just my point of that. That's an example of what we are all basically doing, which is, you know, accentuating the negative and downplaying the positive, at least to ourselves. So that's why that's just one thing that's important to do is, you know, don't compare yourself to other people, because you're almost always going to come on the short end of that stick.
You are here for a reason. You are a unique individual that has a purpose that only you can fulfill. We can't compare ourselves to anybody because they're not us and we're not them. the thing that we can do is live our best life in everything that we do so that we not only just survive, but we thrive with every day that we're living. I really encourage some of you to really take a moment during this commercial break and think to yourself, what are some things that I can say to me to help me thrive? If you want to, hashtag out to Thriving Entrepreneur and let us know the things that you're going to do right now in this moment to live a better life as the best version of yourself that you can. You are listening to Thriving Entrepreneur.
This is the EWN Radio Network.
Hi, I'm Sandra Yancey, founder and CEO of eWomen Network. One of my mottos for business owners is, you can't do it alone. Whether you're in the startup stage of your business or you're scaling, you can't grow without relationships to provide support, wisdom, and new customers. eWomen Network is your home to connect with other women entrepreneurs who've been where you are or are experiencing the same challenges. We have chapters across the U.S. and Canada that have monthly events featuring our trademarked process called accelerated networking to ensure you get the contacts, resources, and leads you need to grow your business. And once you become a member, you get many benefits, including 2 one-on-one coaching sessions, unlimited access to our membership database, your own personal profile page, and discounts on products and services with our business partners such as UPS and American Express Open. Join the eWomen Network community and let us help you live your dream. For details, visit eWomenNetwork.com.
Are you ready to be a celebrity expert in your field? Are you your own best kept secret? Do you have talents you want to share with the world? Are you ready to be seen as an authority? Do you have a message you need to share with the world? You know to your core you can help people if you could just reach them. Kathy and I want to help you share your unique brilliance with the world. Are you ready for this? How would you like to be recognized on top media outlets? What would becoming an Amazon bestseller do for your business? How many people could you inspire? And it doesn't take a lifetime. It doesn't take years. It doesn't take months. In fact, in just 60 minutes, you will become a celebrity expert in your field. In 30 days, you will be a best-selling author, and you will be seen on NBC, CBS, ABC, CNN, Fox, and the Wall Street Journal. How does this work? Will you be interviewed on our show, Thriving Entrepreneur, which will then be broadcast on Blog Talk Radio, iTunes, Stitcher, and many others, as well as promoted to a network that has a database of over 500,000 people. Your expert interview will be published in your very own book, which is guaranteed to hit best-selling author status on Amazon. Your name and the book title will appear in major media outlets, including ABC, NBC, Fox, CNN. We can guarantee that. Plus, as a bonus, you'll get a custom social media package to promote your book and an MP3 of your interview with 5 key tips on how you can repurpose the content for marketing and sales. Don't be the best kept secret. Get ready to play an A game and be the authority in your field. Go to wehelpyouthrive.com and click on the authority package to get yours today.
Welcome back to Thriving Entrepreneur.
This is Steve. You are listening to Thriving Entrepreneur. We're here today with Noah St. John, and he is talking to us about affirmations. How to be able to ask yourself the right questions that empower you to a better life. So what questions are you asking yourself? How many of us find ourselves asking the wrong question? We're saying to ourselves things that are creating answers that we don't want. You know, things like, why am I so broke? Why am I so fat? Why am I so ugly? I mean, if you ask your mind that question, you're going to get an answer for that. And you don't want to ask yourself those questions because, let's be honest, folks, you are amazing. It's not conceit. I've shared this with you before. The true definition of humility is to have a right perspective of yourself. And you are the best you that you can be. Every circumstance that you've been through, every experience that you've had, have made you into this perfectly wonderful creature. So I encourage you, ask yourself some positive questions. What would be some things that you could say to you right now that would be positive and encouraging to you? How about something like, why am I so wonderful? Why do my children love me so much? Why have I had such a huge impact on the world? What's that doing to your mind? I'm interested to see some of your tweets as you guys talk about those kind of things that you're doing.
I mean, I think that the biggest thing in life that we have to come to terms with is the fact that, you know, you were talking about it earlier when you were talking about relationships. Relationships ultimately have to do with that connection. And the things that connect us one to another, I hear this all the time on the show. It's not the positive things. It's not about, you know, those up days, you know, like your wedding or the birth of your kids. I mean, we feel connected to one another when somebody else has something good happen in their life. But the times that we really connect heart to heart are the times when a person says, you know, hey, I've really been struggling with, and then they really are open and honest with a person. That's then when we go, oh, wow, I'm so glad to know that there's somebody else out there that has experienced what I'm going through. I thought I was the only one. It's weird that we all seem to look at our life situation and feel like we're the only one going through it.
You're right.
Can you talk to us a little bit about that, that downside to it? Why is it as people that we are so drawn to, you know, staying stuck as opposed to thriving and living a better life?
We're basically taught to be stuck. That, in my view, Steve, that is what institutions do to us as humans. Looking at the institution of education, for example, in this country, education is about the three R's: read, recite, and regurgitate. And that is, you know, they have to do that. I understand that, because how else are they going to measure, you know, whether a child is getting ahead or not? You know, you have to be able to read, recite, and regurgitate, and you're spitting out all these facts. And okay, well, now Johnny proved that he knows this because he did well on this test. But listen, every parent knows that the institution of education that we have in this country today isn't preparing children for the real world, the new world, the 21st century. It was created, you know, well over 100 years ago for an agricultural society. Well, now we're in the knowledge society, and we all know that it's not working. We all know it's broken, but nobody really seems to know what to do to fix it. You know, what I like seeing is the fact that there are people who are working on it. And even on television, I was seeing that, you know, different networks are really trying new things to get kids involved and parents involved and you know, teachers and the whole thing. So, I mean, that's just one example of how we are taught to be robots, automatons, and just spit out what, you know, what we're supposed to. So, you know, it's not a certain person's fault. You know, you can point wherever you want to, but at the end of the day, as adults, we have to take responsibility. We have to become empowered. We have to empower ourselves to say, hey, I'm going to make choices. I'm not going to go around blaming people. I'm not going to go around pointing the finger. I'm going to say, listen, it's my responsibility, and I'm going to, you know, basically suck it up and say, hey, listen, if I want to live an abundant life, it's up to me to do that. The nice thing is there are so many resources out there to help us do that, and they are available really easier, I think, now than at any time in human history.
And I think the biggest first step that I've found in that is at some point you have to get to a place where you draw a line in the sand. I mean, you referred to it easier. All of Bill Gates' money can't buy back yesterday. So regardless of whether you were an extreme success yesterday or you failed completely and miserably, we have to draw that line in the sand and realize, as my friend Ernie Villanueva says, you know, yesterday is a canceled check. Tomorrow's a promissory note. Today is the only legal tender that we can spend. So we have to decide that we are going to spend that time and we're going to do something positive about it. Answer this question for me if you can, Noah. If you, when you very first discovered this, you know, you said that was 1990. What have you learned?
1997.
Okay. So just almost 20 years ago, over the course of the 20 years, if you could go back and start teaching then what you teach now, what would be the number one thing that you would include in your teaching of affirmations to people that you've learned over the course of this last almost 20 years?
Really, I would the number, the sheer number of success stories from people around the world that we've received is truly staggering. I mean, it is over 120 countries as of this counting that just people who've contacted me and thanked me and shared their stories with me, from people who like there was a reader in Germany named Michael, and he said that he and his wife were about to get a divorce, and they had the divorce papers on the table ready to be signed. They were on the desk. I mean, you can't get any closer to divorce than they're ready to be signed. The papers are done. He somehow found out about me, started listening to my affirmations, shared them with his wife. Long story short, they tore up the divorce papers. They said, we fell in love again. Now we're closer than ever. We do our affirmations every day, and we've never been happier. I mean, just stories like that that are absolutely incredible. And even from kids who are getting better grades, who are feeling more confident, who are sleeping better, overcoming, what's that thing where you can't sleep? What's that thing called where you can't sleep? Insomnia. Yeah.
Insomnia?
During insomnia. So, I mean, just all those types of things like that. So, let alone making really millions of dollars. It's just been an incredible ride. So, I mean, if I were to do anything different, it would just be to be able to tell more people. I mean, you know, what we call ourselves, the folks who practice affirmations, people who, you know, are getting this, we call ourselves affirmers. And we do, you know, we have, you know, a lot of tools to enable people to do that and help them do that, like iAfform audios and affirmware, so you can record your own affirmations and listen to them throughout the day, as well as the books and stuff. But my point is that, you know, we would just love to have more people join the affirmations revolution, because we really believe, us affirmers believe, that it really can change the world.
Do you believe? Can you see how what you do and the intentionality that you take in what you do can change the world? There are so many examples that we've given you across the show of people who their impact on the world was so dramatic in spite of the seemingly small impact that we tend to assign to it. I think of the teacher that Oprah is always talking about, that she would have never been who she was if it hadn't been for her teacher. Billy Graham's mom is another great example of somebody who made an enormous impact on the world because of who they were to the person that they needed to be that person to. Who do you need to impact with your message because of who you need to be in the world? You are listening to Thriving Entrepreneur.
Hi, I'm Sandra Yancey, founder and CEO of eWomen Network. One of my mottos for business owners is, you can't do it alone. Whether you're in the startup stage of your business or you're scaling, you can't grow without relationships to provide support, wisdom, and new customers. eWomen Network is your home to connect with other women entrepreneurs who've been where you are or are experiencing the same challenges. We have chapters across the U.S. and Canada that have monthly events featuring our trademarked process called accelerated networking to ensure you get the contacts, resources, and leads you need to grow your business. And once you become a member, you get many benefits, including 2 one-on-one coaching sessions, unlimited access to our membership database, your own personal profile page, and discounts on products and services with our business partners such as UPS and American Express Open. Join the eWomen Network community and let us help you live your dream. For details, visit eWomenNetwork.com.
Are you ready to be a celebrity expert in your field? Are you your own best-kept secret? Do you have talents you want to share with the world? Are you ready to be seen as an authority? Do you have a message you need to share with the world? You know to your core you can help people if you could just reach them. Kathy and I want to help you share your unique brilliance with the world. Are you ready for this? How would you like to be recognized on top media outlets? What would becoming an Amazon bestseller do for your business? How many people could you inspire? And it doesn't take a lifetime. It doesn't take years. It doesn't take months. In fact, in just 60 minutes, you will become a celebrity expert in your field. In 30 days, you will be a best-selling author, and you will be seen on NBC, CBS, ABC, CNN, Fox, and the Wall Street Journal. How does this work? Will you be interviewed on our show, Thriving Entrepreneur, which will then be broadcast on Blog Talk Radio, iTunes, Stitcher, and many others, as well as promoted to a network that has a database of over 500,000 people. Your expert interview will be published in your very own book, which is guaranteed to hit best-selling author status on Amazon. Your name and the book title will appear in major media outlets, including ABC, NBC, Fox, CNN. We can guarantee that. Plus, as a bonus, you'll get a custom social media package to promote your book and an MP3 of your interview with 5 key tips on how you can repurpose the content for marketing and sales. Don't be the best kept secret. Get ready to play an A game and be the authority in your field. Go to wehelpyouthrive.com and click on the authority package to get yours today.
Welcome back to Thriving Entrepreneur.
Well, so I'm hoping that there are some folks out there that are like, okay, I'm ready. I need now to be empowered with the skills to ask the right kind of questions so that I stop getting the wrong kind of answers. What can a person do to work with you? How can they find out more about affirmations?
It's really simple. Just go to our website, noahstjohn.com. That's my name, NoahStjohn.com, noahstjohn.com. And you can actually download my new book for free. My new book is called Get Your Foot Off the Brake. And so I actually walk you through the 4 steps of affirmations. And, I just invite everyone to download that book for free at noahstjohn.com. Of course, you can get my book of affirmations, which is published by Hay House. That's anywhere books are sold, Amazon, Barnes & Noble, or your local bookstore. And we've got tons of other training programs online and live events as well. You can find out about all that at noahstjohn.com.
So that's noahstjohn.com, noahstjohn.com. He's going to give you his free book, Get Your Foot Off the Brake. He's giving that to you for free to help walk you through all 4 parts of that and begin to really start forming in your life positive, good, and impactful things that can make a difference in your life. So I encourage you, go to noahstjohn.com. So Noah, before we let you go here today, we always want to be good teachers and really leave people something that they can do that they could take action on, like right now? What is a thing a person could do right now today to begin to form their life instead of just firming up their already messed up life?
Well, I think one thing that would be really helpful for people is to do that exercise I shared earlier. Really just write down those four elements, time, energy, relationships, and money. And on a scale from 1 to 10, how stuck or abundant do you feel? 1 being, I'm totally stuck. 10 being, I'm totally abundant. And then once you determine where you feel stuck right now, then that's where you focus. So if you say, hey, listen, I'm tired of feeling like I have too much to do and too little time. I'm tired of feeling I don't have the energy. I'm tired of not having the relationships that I want. And I'm tired of not having the money that I want. Then that's where I'm going to focus right now. And then, you know, wherever you focus, that's what's going to occur into your life. And that's where you're going to bring in new teachings and new teachers. And as I'm sure we all know, when the student is ready, the teacher appears. And that would be a great place to start for all of you right now.
Yeah, I mean, even if you were just to take one of those, you know, and I think the important thing to interject in here is often when we take quizzes like that, we then spin that as another opportunity to beat ourselves up more. You know what I mean? And the concept behind it is not to find another way to make your life even worse, but it's to be able to then focus yourself on improving.
You got it, Steve.
So, again, that's where do you rate on time, energy, relationships, and money? Just a simple 1 to 10 scale, and then work on it. And the other thing I tell you is, I mean, it is really impactful if you come back 30 days, 60 days, 90 days later and look at how do I rate my life just in this little bit of time, and where has it grown in that one area?
So I think that would be great. Yeah, that would be really good. And that's where you want to be focusing and keep moving forward. You know, that's what highly successful people do. You know, even when there are speed bumps, when there's roadblocks, they keep going because they keep their eyes on the prize. And anybody can do that once you make that decision.
The key in that case, again, is to draw that line in the sand and really make that decision. So, Noah, what would be one last thing that you can leave the listeners with that they can really take away feeling positive and encouraged from having listened today?
Well, let me share with you the five words that have really changed my life when I discovered them many years ago. I was really stuck. I was stuck in all those areas, you know, time, energy, relationships, and money. And once I discovered these five words, it started me on a path, you know, a long journey now that has taken me around the world and really helping a lot of folks and really growing the tribe of Afformers. And those five words are: give yourself permission to succeed. Give yourself permission to succeed. Don't let anyone stop you. And don't let anything stop you, especially yourself.
Give yourself permission to succeed. Wow, those are pretty powerful five words.
Mm-hmm.
What would that look like? What would permission to succeed, how would that show up in our life?
Well, I mean, the first thing to do is to understand you know, use affirmations, like I show you again in the book. I do show you that for free. You know, go download that book and you can start using those really right away. And then, you know, I really walk you through a whole process. That's what I've been teaching for 20 years now, is really when I realized that the number one thing that people needed was to give themselves permission to succeed, I realized that I had to create a system to do that. So I've developed an entire system to give people permission to succeed so they can give themselves permission. And really, that's been what's been responsible for, you know, my now being able to build $2 million brands, helping our clients add millions of dollars and find love and so forth. So, I mean, it really is the process. I don't have time to give you the whole thing right now, but I can definitely get you started. You know, just get your foot off the brake, that free book that I mentioned earlier, but that'll get you started right away today.
So I would encourage you right now today, go to noahstjohn.com, get his free book, Get Your Foot Off the Brake, and then do something with it. Get your foot off the brake and really start moving forward and succeeding. Well, Noah, I really appreciate you taking the time today to pour into the lives of the listeners and helping them form a better life.
My pleasure, Steve.
Affirmations. This has been Noah St. John as he has helped us reimagine the possibilities that we can do with the power of the right questions that we ask our mind. I encourage you, ask yourself the empowering questions that are going to make you the best version of yourself that you can be every day of your life as you live as a thriving entrepreneur. I want to remind you, you are uniquely brilliant. You were created for a purpose. The world needs you. Kathy and I are here to help you to live every day of your life as a thriving entrepreneur. Until next time, have a great week.
Thanks for listening to Thriving Entrepreneur today. If you want to get your question answered, send an email to questions@wehelpyouthrive.com. We look forward to you joining us again next time.
Are you ready to be a celebrity expert in your field? Are you your own best kept secret? Do you have talents you want to share with the world? Are you ready to be seen as an authority? Do you have a message you need to share with the world? You know to your core you can help people if you could just reach them. Kathy and I want to help you share your unique brilliance with the world. Are you ready for this? How would you like to be recognized on top media outlets? What would becoming an Amazon bestseller do for your business? How many people could you inspire? And it doesn't take a lifetime. It doesn't take years. It doesn't take months. In fact, in just 60 minutes, you will become a celebrity expert in your field. In 30 days, you will be a best-selling author, and you will be seen on NBC, CBS, ABC, CNN, Fox, and the Wall Street Journal. How does this work? Will you be interviewed on our show, Thriving Entrepreneur, which will then be broadcast on Blog Talk Radio, iTunes, Stitcher, and many others, as well as promoted to a network that has a database of over 500,000 people? Your expert interview will be published in your very own book, which is guaranteed to hit best-selling author status on Amazon. Your name and the book title will appear in major media outlets, including ABC, NBC, Fox, CNN. We can guarantee that. Plus, as a bonus, you'll get a custom social media package to promote your book and an MP3 of your interview with 5 key tips on how you can repurpose the content for marketing and sales. Don't be the best kept secret. Get ready to play an A game and be the authority in your field. Go to wehelpyouthrive.com and click on the authority package to get yours today.